This is the video on the artery supply of the thoracic region. So for better understanding, we have to know about the heart, the artery supply of the heart. This is our heart and artery supply of the heart is right coronary artery and left coronary artery. Right coronary artery arises from the anterior aortic sinus and left coronary artery arises from the posterior aortic sinus. And right coronary artery gives branches like marginal artery and posterior intercostal artery, and left coronary artery gives branches like the left circumflex artery, marginal artery and the anterior interventricular artery. And the area where the two arteries meet on the posterior surface, it is called cross. And the left ventricle pumps the blood into the ascending aorta and arch of aorta, and it finally goes to the descending thoracic aorta. And after crossing the diaphragm, it becomes abdominal aorta and supply the whole part of the body. And arch of aorta has got three branches, that is brachiocephalic trunk, left common carotid artery and left subclavian artery. Brachiocephalic trunk also has two branches, that is right common carotid artery and the right subclavian artery. Right subclavian artery or left subclavian artery has got branches. It is of three parts, first part, second part and third part. The part is divided by the splenous anterior muscle. First part has got three branches, that is vertebral artery, internal thoracic artery and thyrocervical artery. Second part is the costocervical artery and third part is the dorsal scapular artery. For better understanding of the subclavian artery, let's see here. Subclavian artery branches, we can make the mnemonics PITCD, that is vitamin CD, vertebral artery, internal thoracic artery, thyrocervical trunk, costocervical trunk and dorsal scapular artery. The branches of the thyrocervical trunks are the inferior thyroid artery, suprascapular artery and transverse cervical artery. The branches of the costocervical trunk is the deep cervical artery and superior intercostal artery. The superior intercostal arteries has the branches first and second posterior intercostal arteries. Other posterior intercostal arteries is the branches of the descending thoracic aorta 3 to 11. And descending thoracic aorta has also the branches like left brachial artery, pericardial artery, esophageal artery and superior phrenic artery. Inferior phrenic artery is the branch of the abdominal aorta. So the about the subclavian artery. Subclavian artery has important branches which supply the thoracic region. It is internal thoracic artery. Internal thoracic artery extend up to the sixth costal cartilage. Its branches are the pericardiophrenic artery, perforating artery, mediastinal artery, sternal artery, and anterior first 1 to 6 intercostal artery. And rest of the arteries are the branches of the musculophrenic artery. It is the terminal branches of the internal thoracic artery. Another terminal branch of internal thoracic artery is the superior epigastric artery. So when it crosses the first rib, it becomes the axillary artery. Axillary artery also has the three parts, first part, second part and third part. The part is divided by the pectoralis minor muscle. It has got branches. First part has got one branches, that is superior thoracic artery. Second part has got the two branches, that is the acromiothoracic artery and the lateral thoracic artery. And third part has the got branches like subscapular artery, anterior circumflex humeral artery and posterior circumflex humeral artery. When it crosses the teres major muscle, then it becomes brachial artery. So it is the overview of the artery supply of the thoracic region. Thank you.